the sun is shining down on the valley. Hope to be a fly fish to the day that I die. Spring has thawed out the long bitter winter. The water is clear and the skies are blue. I'm standing in the middle of the Delaware River. Might even catch and release one or two. Life is good when I'm wading a river. Gets even better when I cast a fly. If I catch a trout, it don't really matter. It's fun just to be here and give it a try. Stoneflies and caddis in the riffles are plenty. Mayflies are courting on fragrant breeze. Wax wings come down from the heavens, wait for their dinner up in the pine trees. Trout is rising in the far eddy. I make a false cast, then take my aim. If he takes the fly, I'd feel so much better. And if he doesn't, I'll feel no shame. The water is cold and my waders leak. It's raining now on my favorite stream. I'll bear it all, just fished with a feather. So when I sleep, I will have a sweet dream. Life is good when I'm wading a river. Gets even better when I cast a fly. Don't really matter, it's fun just to be here and give it a try. Ripples and waves, pools and eddies, trout are rising for the dry fly. And the sun is shining down on the valley. Hope to be a fly fishing till the day that I die. Spring has thawed out the long bitter winter. The water is clear and the skies are blue. I'm standing in the middle of the Beaverkill River. Might even catch and release one or two. Ripples and waves, pools and eddies, trout are rising for the dry fly.
Doing? Welcome to show, I don't know, number five maybe. Today we're going to do an elk hair caddis. And the reason we're doing an elk hair caddis is because I believe that you got to have an elk hair caddis. Got something on my book. Anyway, and the reason why I believe the caddis is not given all the credit it should, but it in today's fly fishing world, it's I don't know why, but it should get a little more credit. It's a real fun fly to use. You can skitter it on the surface. You can drag it across the surface. You can splash it on the surface. You can let it sink and then lift it. If you use a emerging caddis, you can lift them pretty fast, like they're going shooting right to the surface. They're a lot of fun to use. And there's a lot of different species. Here in my book, there's the snail maker caddis, makes a hut out of into a snail kind of case. Here's a micro caddis, uses sand to make a little hut. The longhorn caddis uses a little bit bigger material than the micro caddis, but it's grains of sand, and they make it a little web, and they spin it into a little hut. Here's the lipo Stominad casemaker caddis. He uses little chunks of bark. It looks like pine tree bark to make his hut. And then you have the humpless casemaker caddis fly, which uses a blade of grass and folds it into a nice square shape. And it's, I think I have some right here on my rock. That's the humpless caddis right there. And then you have the saddle casemaker stoneflies. These use clumps of stone and just kind of pile them there. And the unid casemaker does the same kind of thing, but he uses a couple of different types of material, the bigger stones and the smaller stones. And then you have the northern casemaker, who uses blades of grass and pine needles and things like that. So it might be more where there's pine trees type debris in the water. And then you have the northern casemaker. These guys, you make cases in three different varieties. Here's one that uses tree branches right here on my rock. And then sand, and then other forms of stone. So it can pretty much vary. Here's the strong case maker caddis. This guy uses sand, and they may be right here. The sand is stuck to the rock, and they make these little adobe huts like things. And then you have the giant case maker caddis, who makes a hut out of twigs, little pieces of stone or twigs, and folds them around like a little log house. You have the common net spinner, who makes like a funny looking net. And what they do is they their heads stick out, and they feed on floating algae and micro whatever they feed on as it floats by. Here's the finger net caddis flies, and here's the trumpet net. I don't know what kind of case they make, but it's pretty interesting. And then you have the free living caddis, which is green, and that's why we tie the green weenie, or the green, well, it's not the green weenie, the green weenie is a stonefly, I think, but the green caddis is a caddis pupa. It's a free living caddis, and they typically are found in like weed beds or grass beds. So you can see that the caddis fly has a pretty good family history right there. So today we're going to do an elk hair caddis, and I typically tie these in size 18, although they can be tied in different sizes larger than that. The black caddis and things like that can be tied a little bit bigger. You'll have to go to the stream and look at the insects and see what we got. This is a tiny hook, and I'm just hoping you'll be able to see it. It's a pretty easy fly to tie, and again, I have this on my website, so you can always go to my website at homepage.mac.com/AVKurt. Okay, if you go to there, you'll see the website. On that website, you see some pictures of me fishing and stuff like that, but what I want you to look for is the videos. You have to have QuickTime player to see them, and some may take depending on your internet speed, if you're dial up or whatever, some may take a while because they are fairly long films. They aren't just your typical quickies. They are, fairly long video, but you'll see how to tie several flies on there. My stone fly, the hare's ear nymph, and some other flies, on there. The other thing you can look for on my website is I have Hazard's Hook. That's the Ale Hazard Chapter Trout Unlimited's newsletter. And that comes out just about once a month throughout the whole year. And I post it on my website there. So you'll be able to read back issues and all the way for the last almost 2 years since I've been publishing it. You're going to need Adobe Reader to view that. Okay, so keep that in mind. Let's get going with the elk hair caddis. Where's my elk hair? I lost my, oh, here it is. I got a little elk hair here. I'm going to tie this. I have my Rwsea nymph dubbing that I had last week for the Rwsea nymph. I have that left over. I'm going to use that. I'm going to use the elk hair. And I may use a little hackle to wrap around. I may palmer a hackle around the body if I can find one. I know I got some here somewhere. Yeah, here we go. Here's a nice grizzly. This'll make nice legs for my Rwsea. Okay. So we're gonna plumber this over the body, and that's basically it. So it's a real simple fly to tie, but it's a fly you gotta have. And what you may want to do is tie these up in olive, black, and tan are probably the three predominant colors. And then in various sizes, between 18 is about the smallest I tie with these. And I do an 18 tan caddis. The black caddis can be a little bit bigger than that, but there's also a size 18 black caddis. So, just sit down and tie about a dozen of each color in about three or four different sizes, and you'll be an expert at the elk hair caddis. But let's get started. First, as always, we're going to take our thread, make sure our bobbin's got good tension on it, and we're going to place our hook in the vise. You want your hook to be level, okay? So that when your thread is on there, it doesn't fall off the end, okay? And it's a simpler way to work. And again, I pull the thread towards me and then wrap around towards the front and then go back over the thread, and that holds it down. And if I hold this tag end at a 45 degree angle, I can wrap fairly fast. And it keeps it nice and even. And this thread is a flat thread, which means it's made up of many different small fibers, so it's a good thread to use because it winds flat and keeps it a low profile. Okay, now we're going to need a tail, or not a tail, but a hackle to wind around that, okay? And whenever I palmer a hackle, I like to start with the tip, so we're going to take our tip and measure it. Okay, pull some of the hackle back, and then we're going to trim that tip off, leaving a little nub there so we can tie in. And that'll help hold it. Using the pinch method, I pinch the feather and the hook and the thread down, and once it's tied on there, I'm all set. Now, you bring your thread back to the bend. You're going to keep coming back to that position. Now, I'm going to wax that thread, because I'm going to put my dubbing on. And we're going to take some of our Rwsea nymph dubbing that we used last week. This makes a good tan caddis. And you can see you don't need a lot of materials because you use some of the same colors for different flies. I'm going to spin that right on there nice and tight. And which way is my thread going? And then we're going to wrap that forward, putting one wrap in front of the other, and try to keep it nice and tapered, make a nice body, a little bit bigger towards the front. Our dubbing's kind of flying all over the place, no problem. Now we're going to quickly find the hackle pliers. We're going to clamp on to the end of that tackle that we're going to wrap forward. Again, using, we're going to palmer this. Oh, and it broke. Start over. Oh well, no problem. I guess we won't use a hackle on there. We'll go right to our elk hair. It doesn't matter. You can use hackle palmered over the body or not. So if the fiber breaks while you're tying it, don't worry. Don't fret none. What we're going to do is we're going to take our elk hair and cut it. Pull the little fluff out of there as much as we can. We're going to place this in a hair stacker right here. We're going to place those fibers in there, pump them down, and then we're going to tap this on the table. Okay? And then we're going to carefully pull it out, and all those fibers are lined up nice and neat now. I'm going to pull that right out of the thing, the hair stacker. Now, that's way too much fur. So I'm going to take some of that out of there. We don't need all that. That's a little bit too big of a clump. That looks like a good bunch right there. Okay? Pull some of these that are out of there. That's a good little bunch right there. That's a nice little elk hair caddis. Now you don't want to cut this end yet because you'll see what's going to happen. What we're going to do is we're going to wrap loosely through there a few times. Okay? We're going to pull up and then start wrapping tighter. You always want to pull up because if you pull down, it'll spin around there. Okay? So once we got that on there, now we're going to pull that fur up and out of the way, wrap around the eye nice and tight, get it right up to that fur. We're going to do a half hitch. Couple of them. So we got several half hitches on there. Okay. Now we're going to reach up here and pull all that extra tag end part off, and we're going to cut it at an angle so that it makes a nice ugly little head there. Okay. That's very important. You don't want a neat head. You want a nice head there. Okay. Kind of like a punk rocker right there. And that's your elk hair caddis. That's all you gotta do for the elk hair caddis. That's the elk hair caddis. Very simple fly to tie. And again, my hackle broke, so I couldn't palmer hackle around there. But you get the idea. Just go ahead and try it. Wrap a hackle around the body and make it so that it's like legs, and it helps it float. Another thing you can do is a skittering caddis has a hackle wound at the shoulder or at the head, okay? So you can actually wrap a hackle around that head, and you can clip this neater but put a hackle on the front. And that's called the skittering caddis. So by learning a little bit about a caddis, it'll help you on the stream. By tying a bunch of these up, it'll help you on the stream. You'll catch more fish, you'll have a little more fun fishing, and keep in mind that you want to tie some of these up way ahead of time, because this fly is just phenomenal. If you go fishing down on the beaver kill and you don't have a caddis fly, you're going to be real sorry, because there's times where they're hitting a caddis and that's it. They won't touch anything else. Once in a while they'll hit a red quill, but when they're going for the caddis, they're going for the caddis, and they mean business. So, I suppose I'll show you a clip of, I have no idea. I have no idea. So just sit back, enjoy the clip, and we'll see you next week. We're going to, maybe I'll show something of the kids' derby or something like that. Anyway, what else did I want to say? I guess that's it. Yeah, that's it. That's it for today's show. So we want to, I want to remind you that it's your show. I just do the show, but I'm looking for special guests to be on the show and tie flies. So with all that being said, contact me at avkurt@mat.com. And next week, I think we'll do a dry fly. We'll do a light Cahill. How's that sound? Sounds good to you? Sounds good to me. Or maybe we'll do a Quill Gordon. Or maybe we'll do a Red Quill. Maybe we'll do a Gray Fox variant. These are brown drake spinners flying about. They're like,
you should turn around because their back is a cover with it.
They're like all over.
They're all female bugs on you too.
Wow, look at that. They're all over me.
You're just a real hunk.
Yeah.
A couple of fish came right out of the water on the way down, but not too much wind.
Yeah, it'll be.
There's more bugs on the water here, though, on this side than there was on the other side.
Spinners now.
Oh, okay. Right to your 10 o'clock. This is rising, okay, buddy? About 10 feet from the boat. 10 o'clock.
Oh, right here in front of the boat. Just flick it right in the front of the boat.
There you go. No, you gotta jump. That'll work. Gotta go.
Don't worry, the hook comes out.
I don't want to hit him.
We're catching perch on the fly here on Skinny Atlas Lake. They're rising everywhere. Oh, look at it. Ow.
You stumble and step on that. Slide back.
Why don't you move it out of your way? Move it off to the side. Right by your right leg.
Okay,
you'll crush all those flies. You'll have to retie every one of them for me and send them to me. Thank you.
amazement when there aren't more rises.
I think they're all close to the lake. All the fish are up there.
That's incredible.
They're all where?
There's one right
at
over
that one place here. Fish?
Yeah, it was a nice fish.
Here, perch on the fly. This week on Babe Winkerdink's In Fishing. Bob Mead's running our guide service today, and Rick Nero's hosting our lodge accommodations. Yuta's our guide.
Gilly.
I'm the perfectionist.
And we're going after perch on the fly today. What?
I came home and told you that very thing, but you didn't pay me, no, never mind.
I did too.
You did not.
I did too.
You put your car in and you went back to play that stupid game.